Hello, I want to show you how we can work with images in Visual Studio with Web Essentials. And let's take a look at some of the new capabilities that we have in Web Essentials 1.7 for Visual Studio 2013. So here I have a website, and it's just a standard MVC website that you see right here. And now I want to add some images to this site. So let's just take a look here quickly. It's just, as you can see, the standard website. And now let's go get some images. And in this case, I actually want to add some screenshots. So I use Office, the OneNote app in Office, to do screenshots. So let me just do a quick one of the logo, Visual Studio logo up here. And I'm going to copy that to the clipboard. Okay, I'm going to go back into Visual Studio, and I want the image to show up at the top of my page right here. Now, normally I should have saved the image to disk and added it to my project and so on, but now the image is in my clipboard, and I can simply just paste it in, Control V for pasting. And when I do that, and there's an image there, Web Essentials will recognize that and will ask me if I want to save that image. And say, yes, I do, and this was the logo of Visual Studio, so I'm kind of going to call it vs.png here. And we can see automatically it added the image here. I can hover it, and it looks very nice. Now let's go get another image here. Let's just do the Web Essentials logo. Again, we're going to do the same thing. Add it to clipboard, and just save it to my project. And we can see here they just show up. I don't have to show hidden files and folders and include in project. They're just part of my project already. So that makes it really easy. But if we paid close attention to the status bar, we can see that as we pasted in the image, Web Essentials compressed it, in this case by 20%. So it actually makes the image a smaller file size. And it does that without sacrificing quality of the image. This is what's called a lossless optimization. And it uses the same tools as for image optimization as you would find in smushit.com, punypng.com, and kraken.io. Some of these industry standard command line tools that Web Essentials runs behind the scene. And that makes it really, really easy. And we also have, if you just want to optimize our images, let's say I have some images of hats right here. I can just click any image, go to Web Essentials, and say Optimize Image. Or I can do it on an entire folder. Let's just try that. Optimize Images, and let's take a look at what happens here. So it recognized that there are four images in my selection that can potentially be optimized. And we can see here that all four images could be optimized, and we saved 18 kilobytes and a total of 10%. Just with one click. So that's really, really nice. And it, as I said, it doesn't lose quality. It's lossless. It keeps your transparency of your images and so on. So it's really a nice tool to have at your fingertips here. Another thing that we might want to do, let's just take a look actually at what this page looks like here. So let's just update it. We can now see here on our page we have these two images showing up. But if I want to do website optimization, sometimes I want to take a lot of images and create an image sprite. An image sprite means that I take a lot of small images and basically combine them into one large image. And that saves a lot of requests that the browser have to make to the server. But when we do that, we can't use the image tag as we have right here. So let's do something else. Let's create a div and give it a class name of VS. And we're going to do another div and call it here Web Essentials. So now we have two divs. And of course, that means that we no longer have our images. We need to do something more. So let's create a sprite. And I want to create a sprite out of these two images. So I'm going to select them and go up here and say Create Image Sprite. Here we go. And what do we want to call it? It suggests that we just call it mySprite.sprite. That's fine. And then it creates this XML file for us. And in here we can set some settings for what our image sprite is going to do here. One of them is whether or not it should optimize the image. So the optimization step that we just saw before, we can do this automatically here by setting this to true or false. And of course, you get intelligence for all of this. Also, which direction should or which orientation should the images be stacked in the final compound image? It could be vertical or horizontal. And finally, what is the output file format, PNG, GIF, and JPEG? PNG is probably what most people are going to use, so let's just stick with that. And then finally, we have all our images. Now, I can come in here and add other images afterwards, simply just add a new file element with a new image path right here. So that's the sort of the settings file for my image, my definition file. And if we open it up, we can see that it already produced our PNG. And let's just open it here in the Visual Studio Image Editor here. We can see that we now have these two images side by side. This green stuff you see over here is just the way Visual Studio shows transparency. So there's actually nothing here. But the good thing is that in a PNG, transparent pockets, like we see right here, doesn't actually take up any space really. So don't be too alarmed that you see some empty slots. And if we look under the PNG file, we have a lot of other stuff going on here. We have a CSS file, less a map file, which is JSON, and a SAS file. And these are examples on how to use this sprite. So if we open the CSS file, we can see here's an example, and here are the actual values that you need to add to your own CSS to be able to use the sprite. And you can see here we move the background position so that it automatically works with our sprite. On this website, I'm actually using less. So let's just take a look at this less file. Now, this is a little bit special. So this is the same for less as well as for SAS, that it creates mixins. So this is a mixin that is that can be used directly from our own less files. We don't have to copy and paste anything. So let's go and take a look at our less file. I've cheated, and I've already created an import of this sprite file. And now I have to just simply map my new HTML div elements right here with the image sprites. So let's go do that. So we go in here and say, yep, class VS. And now I'm going to call this mixin that was defined in here that was automatically generated by Web Essentials when I did my sprite. And I'm going to call the mixin here called sprite-vs. So that's very easy. Let's do the same for Web Essentials. We're gonna call the sprite-we like this. And we can see here how it just shows up now. This is very, very simple. Both the images show up, and we have our image sprite. So we took two separate images and combined them into one, and we can now do tricks like this. Very, very cool stuff. Now let's take a look at another scenario with images. So in this case, I want to use an image here, myhat.png, as my background image. So I can just drag that directly onto the CSS editor, or less, as what I'm using here in this case. And we can get a nice preview here so we can see what we're dealing with. And sometimes when we want to do website optimizations, we can do Base64 inlining of an image into the CSS file itself. And the CSS editor provides us through Web Essentials with a little smart tag here, where we can either optimize the image, so this is the exact same as, you know, right-clicking the image and say optimize image, but we can do it directly here in the CSS editor, and by the way, also in HTML on the image element. But here we were going to choose the second option, embed as Base64 data URI. So let's click this guy, and we get a very long string of Base64 encoded characters here, and we can see that it also adds for IE 6 and 7 this star background dash image property. So if we don't care about IE6 and 7, we can just delete this line. That's all fine. Sometimes you just see this one file, and let's say that you make a change to the original file. It would be nice and easy if you could just open the smart tag here again and say re-embed data URI. Okay, so it actually knows where on disk the original image came from, and you can now re-embed it. So imagine that your designer made a little change to the image, and you can just go in here and very easily re-embed it. But you can also optimize a data URI. So here we can see we have 38,000 characters is the base64 encoded string. So now let's try to optimize it. So we run this, and we can take a look here at the status bar. That it's already done, and it optimized it by 22%. And if we collapse this guy, we can see we're down to a flat 30,000 characters. So not only can the optimizer optimize physical images on disk, but it will also optimize your base64 encoded images, either from CSS, the CSS editor, as I'm showing you right here, or the exact same thing shows up in HTML, and the same smart tag on image elements, as you see right here. Thanks for watching.